Good morning, friends. We are discussing the topic of professional misconduct and the disciplinary action to be taken by the concerned Bar Council. You might have noticed the Bar Council of Kerala issued a show cause notice to an advocate, Kesari Krishnan Nair, for his vulgarization of the profession and for his disclosing the facts against the trust of his client while giving an interview to a news channel. I am sure you are in the knowledge of the seizure of 30 kgs of gold worth about 15 crores from a diplomatic bag in Trivandrum Airport. Right, so the diplomat bag actually reached the Trivandrum Airport on 30th June. And in the name of some of that is Rashid Khamis Ali, because it's a diplomatic bag relating to United Arab Emirates. His name is still lingering, but I'm claiming it. I'm actually cutting it. Right. So, actually, this man, he is not in India. He went away to some other place. So, of course, you may be knowing, according to Vienna Convention, the diplomatic bags cannot be checked and they can be handed over to their authorized persons. So here the customs officials, they got a tip off and they seized the bag when Mr. Sarit, previously PRO in the United Arab Emirates, he wanted to steal the credentials, he wanted to take away the bag, of course using the false credentials he wanted to take away, but he was arrested, and of course it led to the arrest of another woman by name Swapna Suresh, who is also working on outsourcing basis in the IT department of CM office in Kerala state. Of course she is reported to be close to that Shiv Shankar, who is the IT secretary and also principal secretary. Of course he is suspended. Of course it has created a heavy political issue. Let us not bother about the same. Coming to the legal points as to how the issue has happened, right? So now you have to go to the international law. According to Vienna Convention, the diplomatic bags, they have to be sorted out, they have to be sent out without any checking. So they have got that immunity. You may be knowing Article 361 of the Constitution of India, it also gives immunity to the diplomats. Yes, their baggage need not be checked. There should be no customs duty. They can straight away enter the plane. Like that, their immunities are there. You cannot file a case against them also. Here the problem is this Rashid Khamis Ali, he was outside India. So, in his name, and that is taking the power of attorney, Mr. Sarit P.S., who was previous employee, he came there and he was arrested, followed by the arrest of Swapna Suresh. Now, this Sarit P.S., he is represented by the advocate Kesari Krishnan Nair, on whom this video is going to be made now. Right? So, the incident, the arrest was taken place on 5th July 2020, and of course the National Investigation Agency has stepped in to investigate the matter, because it is a case relating to Foreign Exchange Maintenance Act and ED. All these people, they will come into existence and they will do their job. So for this matter, we have to congratulate the state of Kerala, because the Director General of Police Kerala, he has offered support to the National Investigation Agency in pursuit of their investigation. Thereby, they are able to arrest the so-called Sarit, as well as Swapna Suresh and some other persons also. Right. Now, we are coming to the core issue. On 16th July 2020, this advocate, Krishnan Nair, he has attended a TV interview by Asia Net, Asia Net news channel. They have made a show with him. So he has spoken, of course he has agreed that he was representing Sarith PS, who worked as a PRO in and Swapna Suresh. Both of them worked as public relations officers and front office in the United Arab Emirates consulate located in Trivandrum. The advocate, that means previously there were some cases against Sarith PS, right? So he appeared on his behalf in so many cases. So while giving the interview, he disclosed that he followed on the request of that woman, Swapna Suresh, that woman Swapna, he followed her in the car along with her husband and son, and they went into the house of Sarith PS. So the house of Sarith PS, they went there, and of course he says that after reaching the house, he came to know that Sarith was taken into custody, that the customs people raided his house and they have found 6 diplomatic bags in this house. So all these things were revealed to him only after reaching Sarith's house. Actually, the mother of Sarith disclosed this to Swapna Suresh. Of course, Swapna Suresh hugged her and she said that Swapna Suresh would bring back her son from police custody, that means on bail or something like that, and saying so, he has slipped his tongue in. She said that on her way to Bangalore, she stated like this. Of course, she was arrested at Bangalore, right? Now, the point is here, see, please refer to rule number 15 of the actually rule number 17, let us discuss about rule number 17. Rule number 17 of the rules of professional conduct and etiquette for the advocates. Rule number 17 says that about the professional communications which I wanted to tell. So here you have to remember more on section 126 of the Indian Evidence Act. Indian Evidence Act 126 says about the professional communication, that means the advocate should not really reveal anything against to his client, even though the client inform him. Simply to say, suppose if the client comes and says that he murdered A, the advocate need not inform the court, they need not inform the police. Even he can refuse to say what his client told him. This is what is the protection given under section 126 of the Indian Evidence Act. Likewise, rule 17 also tells about advocate shall not disclose any communication made to him by the client except with the permission of the client. Of course, if the client says, please go and inform the police that I committed this murder, I want to surrender the police, yes, he can definitely inform. And second point, section 126, clause 2 says, any fact observed by him, any fact observed by the lawyer, so during the course of his employment as an advocate. Here the fact, this is the main problem. The fact is that she was going to Bangalore and he accompanied them to the house of Sarith. All these things he should not have disclosed. By disclosing the same, she was arrested. Of course, not only on this information, police have got their own information. But anyway, this has been a leading clue in information. So actually, having imposed or reposed a lot of trust on the advocate, normally they took him to the places they wanted to visit, but he should not have disclosed. Since he disclosed, it has become viral, and ultimately the Bar Council of the state of Kerala, they have given a notice, a show cause notice to the advocate as to why professional misconduct should not be taken against him, and of course he was given 2 weeks time. Here the Bar Council has clearly stated, as per rules of the practice, rules of professional conduct, an advocate at all times comport himself in manner befitting his status. He should not behave like an ordinary man. He should like behave. He should behave as though he is befitting an advocate, because advocacy is a noble profession and advocate is an officer of the court, and he is a privileged member of the community, and he is a gentleman. So he should bear in mind all these things. And of course, for the people, for the ordinary people, it may not be lawful. The ordinary people, other politicians, other people, they can talk whatever they like. But as an advocate, you should have your own limitations. You should actually properly behave as an advocate. For others, it may be lawful or it may not be moral. But because he is a person other than a bar. So even in his non-professional capacity, so while speaking to the news channel, even not an advocate, because once he started practicing as an advocate, he should keep up the dignity, decency and decorum of the professional advocate. Now, the Bar Council of India has come down heavily on him, stating that he has literally vulgarized the legal profession. And therefore, he was given the show cause notice and asked to respond as to why disciplinary proceedings should not be initiated against him, because he has violated the rules of professional conduct and etiquette. Right? So, in the TV interview, he disclosed the client interest and thus violated the professional, because he said the client's interest is that she wants to get Sarit from the police custody. So this he should not have informed, right? So now, of course, let us see what will happen and what reply he will write. Here, now you have to think of the defense point also. Defense is that he has already told, I do not know. Till I reached the house of Sarit, I did not know that his house was raided and he was taken into custody. Who will believe this? Already, because Swapna Suresh, why should she visit the house of Sarit? Only to check, since he was already, his house was raided. Of course, this is all afterthought, but whatever it is, definitely he may be taken to the task of professional misconduct, of course. Well, let us wait, because it is actually naive to say at this initial stage that some disciplinary action will be taken against him. We have to think over the matter. The disciplinary committee should decide the issue. Then only we can offer opinion. Till such time, we can't say anything. But the fact is that Mr. Krishnan or Kesari Krishnan Nair, he was given a show cause notice of professional misconduct in violation of Rule 17. I think Rule 15 also better we see. Rule 15, it says, it shall be the duty of advocate fearlessly to uphold the interest of his client in all fair and honorable means without any regard to himself or other. Yes, that is the job of an advocate. Where he failed, he has followed him and all these things. Anyway, the Rule 17 is the most appropriate rule to be here. So let us see what will happen. Thank you.